मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, कम बैक टू आवर टॉपिक लीनियर इक्वेशंस हैविंग ओनली वन वेरिएबल. सो वी हैव स्टडीड हाउ टू सॉल्व सिंपल इक्वेशंस, दैट मींस ओनली वन साइड व्हेन वेरिएबल इज लाइंग, हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व सिंपल इक्वेशंस. वी हैव सिंप्लीफाइड अदर एज वेल एज सम ऑफ द वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स, हाउ वी आर यूजिंग इन आवर डेली लाइफ सिचुएशन, सच टाइप ऑफ कंडीशंस ऑल्सो वी हैव सिंप्लीफाइड. नाउ ऑन दैट वी डिड सम ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज प्रॉब्लम ऑल्सो. Problems also. So in all those examples, exercise problems and applications, we got a variable only one side. And after that, variable lying on both the sides, how to simplify the direct equations we have did. Now we are going to apply some of the. We are going to take some of the examples which how we are applying in our daily life situation. So some of the applications. How we are getting that variable on both the sides, how we are getting and how we need to simplify. So we are going to learn today those topics only. So listen here. So we are solving a linear equation. Which is having variables on its two sides. Variables on two sides. Okay. For this, we are going to solve the word problem. Some of the applications of this type of equations. How we are simplifying. So for that, I am going to give the examples today. Okay. Now my first example is example 13. If L is parallel to M. P is a transversal. In the following figure, then find x value. Okay, so find x value. So what is the figure observed? I'm drawing here. L, M, both are parallel lines. So whenever parallel line and transversals we are getting, how to simplify? We did several problems in 7th class. So now observe the question. Here 5x degrees given. And here 2x plus 24 degrees. So like this they are given in the question. Okay, observe here they are given E, F. Okay, now observe the question. Find the value of X, we need X. So observe what is the conditions they are given. L is parallel to M, P. So again I have revised the topic also, parallel lines and transversals. So for that, what are the given angles we need to find? At E, 5x we have and at F we have 2x plus 24. So observe these two angles, how are they lying for transversal? Both are lying one side, same side. Okay, both are same side, right side. 5x also right side, 2x plus 24 also right side for transversal P. Okay. L and M are parallel lines and P is a transversal. 5x and 2x plus 24 both are lying same side of the transversal. And what is the x value? So now use the condition. So they are lying same side of the transversal. So which angle is lying same side of the transversal in case of parallel lines? Which angle is lying same side of the transversal? Corresponding angles and in interior angles. But observe here, 5x co-interior angles. 5x and 2x plus 24. 5x is exterior angle. 2x plus 24 is interior. Both are lying same side of the transversal. So given angles are corresponding angles. So what I am giving, already we know this, but for your understanding purpose I am doing. 5x degrees and 2x plus 24 degrees. So before that, given L and M parallel line, P is a transversal. So they only given, both are parallel lines and these two, P is the transversal. 5x and 2x plus 24 are lying same sides of the transversal, same side of the transversal, and one is interior. So which one is interior here? 2x plus 24 degrees is interior, inside of L and M. 5x is exterior, and one is exterior. Therefore, 5x comma 2x plus 24 degrees are corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. Yes. So, in case of parallel lines, corresponding angles are equal. Therefore, since L is parallel to M, 5x is equal to 2x plus 4. Corresponding angles are equal in case of parallel lines. That's it. See, observe now. X is left side we have and x from right side also we have. So, variable lying on both the sides. Okay. That in this case, what I told you? Bring the variable terms, all the variable terms, one side, constant terms, another side. So, 5x plus 2x by bringing this side, it will become minus 2x is equal to 24 is already there. That's all. Any constant, another constant number we didn't have. Now, 5x minus 2x is equal to 3x is equal to 24. So, x will be equal to 24 by 3. 3 ones are 3 eights. X is equal to 8. So, what is the x value? 8. That's all. Check whether your answer is correct or not. 5x, 5 eights are 40. LHS is 40. 2x plus 24. 2 eights are 16. 16 plus 24. 40. So both are correct. Okay. Now one more example. Example 14. Hema is years older than her daughter Damini. Her daughter Damini. So observe the first condition. Hema is 24 years older than her daughter Damini. That means Hema's age is 24 years more than Damini. Okay, so whose age is what we don't know. Okay, now keep like that only. After that, 6 years ago, 6 years ago, Hema was thrice as old as Damini. Find their present ages. So I am explaining, listen. Hema is 24 years older than her daughter Damini. 6 years ago, Hema was thrice as old as Damini. Find their present ages. So first of all, what I am doing? Whose age we need to take as a variable? So as I told you, Hema's age represented in terms of her daughter Damini. So compulsory second person. Who is the second person here? Damini. Her age we need to take as variable. So let Damini's present age is equal to X years. So we can use any variable, not only X. So they are given. Hema's age will be, Hema's present age will be equal to, Hema is 24 years older than her daughter Damini. Her daughter Damini is X years. Older means more. By how much? 24 years. That is X plus 24 years is Damini's age. Sorry, Hema's age. Okay. Damini's present age is X, then Hema's present age will become X plus 24 years. Now coming to the next condition, whatever given. 6 years ago, Hema was thrice as old as Damini. First of all, 6 years ago, what is their ages? We will find. So 6 years ago, ago means past, that it means before. Okay, for suppose, now your age is 12 years, for suppose. 12 years. 2 years before, what is your age? 12 minus 2, that is 10. So 6 years ago, Damini's age will be equal to x minus 6 years. Yes, ago they are telling, so minus. Latter means plus we have to take. And Hema's age will become X plus 24 minus 6. That is nothing but X plus 24 minus 6 is 18. So X plus 18 years. Now in the question, another condition also given, that is Hema was thrice as old as Damini. So 6 years ago, 6 years ago their ages are this one. Hema was, that means given, Hema's age 6 years ago is equal to thrice of Damini. Okay, Hema's age 6 years ago is X plus 18 years. And thrice means 3 into Damini's age 6 years ago is X minus 6. That's all. Simplify both. So here we got the equation like this. X plus 18 is equal to 3 into X minus 6. Like this we got. So first of all, remove the bracket as I told you before. X plus 18 is equal to 3 into X 3X minus 3 6 is 18. So bring x terms one side and constants one side. So x here only I kept. Plus 3x by bringing this side minus 3x is equal to minus 18 we have already. Bring this plus 18 also this side, that is minus 18. Now minus 3 plus 1, that is minus 2x is equal to, both are negative values, so addition. 18 plus 18, 36. Then x will be equal to minus 36 is at right side. So here minus 2 is in 2. Bring this side by minus 2. Minus minus will get cancelled. 2 1s are 2 18s are. So x is equal to 18 years. That means Damini's present age is equal to 18 years. And Hema's present age will be 18 plus 24, which is equal to 42 years. Okay, if you have any doubts, take any of the equation. This equation take and check whether your answers are correct or not. 18 plus 18 is equal to 36. 3 into 18 minus 6 is 12. 12 3 is 36. So this equation is satisfied. Okay, now coming to the next type of question. So whenever we are getting the equations in case of ages problem related to ages, profit and loss, sorry, maths problem. Okay, and like parallel lines, transversal, all those cases we are getting the equations only. Now coming to another type of question. Example 15. My question is, in a 2-digit number, the sum of the 2 digits is 8. So some otherwise difference also they will give. The sum of the 2 digits is 8. Sum of the digits is 8. If 18 is added, added to the number, if the digits are reversed, find the number. Okay, now for this, see if you are getting, suppose for objective question, if you got this question, in that case we can do in easiest way. What is given? The 2 digits in the number, and sum of those 2 digits is equal to 8. So what I am taking, what is the sum of what are the possibilities to get the sum is equal to 8 of 2 numbers? So if I am taking 1, 1, 7, 1 plus 7 is equal to 8 is one possibility. See, this is shortcut method, just to attempt objective type questions. I am explaining in this way. After that I will give how we will do by procedure. Okay, so 1, 7 is one possible pair. After that 6. 2 plus 6 is equal to 8, and now 3 plus 5 is equal to 8, 4 plus 4 is equal to 8, 5 plus 3 means again that combination only, digits are same. So till you are getting equal, leave. Okay, 1, 7, 2, 6, 3, 5, 4, 4, like this 4 possible pairs are there whose sum is equal to 8. Now if I am taking 17, my first number 17, if 18 is added to these two numbers, add 8 plus 7 is 5, 15, 35, I got as the result. But what are the given condition? When we are adding 18 in a 2-digit number, sum is 8. 18 is added to the number, its digits are reversed. If I am doing addition, I must get the reverse order. Means whatever number I have here, I have to get reversely number. If 17 I have here, I must get 71. But I did not get, I got 35. So this is not a required pair. Now coming to the second pair of the numbers, 26. Add 18, 8 plus 6, 14, 2 plus 2, 4, 44 I got. But I must get 62 when I am adding 18 according to the condition. So this one also not a required pair. Now go through with the 3 and 5. So 35, add 18, 8 plus 5, 13, 1 plus 1, 2 plus 3, 5. What is the number by getting reversely? 53. 53 we got. So this is the required pair. Okay, I hope you understood me. So they are given sum of the numbers is equal to 8. So possible pairs whose sum is equal to 8, write down. Take 2 digits. Write, list the pairs of the digits whose sum is equal to 8. After getting that, form the number, addition they are telling, no? So add 18. Form the smaller number when they are given addition. If subtraction given means instead of 17, take 71. Okay. Now, so like this, and add and check the result whether you are getting reversely. If the digits get reversed, that is the condition. So whether the digits are reversed or not, you need to check. So 26 reversed number is 62, but 62 we did not get. And 17 we must get 71, but 71 we didn't get. 35 reverse number is 53. So while we are adding 18, we got 53. That means this is the required number. So if that is the type of objective, like this you can simplify, no problem. But coming to its original procedure. How we can simplify this type of question using equations. Okay, so now what I am giving, let the two digit number in a two digit number sum of the digits is equal to 8. So what I am doing, let it is very clear, two digit numbers are telling what are the places in two digit number, ones, tens. So let once digit of the number is equal to x. So given sum of the two digits is equal to 8, they only given. So one of the number is x. Suppose in 8 one of the number is 5, what will be the other number? 8 minus 5, that is 3. Yes or no? So 5, one number is 5. When I will get 8 as the result, if I have taken 3, then only 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. So here I am taking one of the number is x. Then I have to get 8 only. So what will be this number? 8 minus x. 8 minus 5 is equal to 3. Okay, 8 minus x. So once digit I have taken x, therefore tenth digit of the number will be equal to 8 minus x. See, for suppose I have a number 58. Okay, now what I'm writing, how can I get this number? Observe, it is 5 is in tens place, 5 into 10 plus 8 is in ones place, 8 into 1. Yes or no? So the digit in the ones place 8 into 1. The digit in the tens place is 5, 5 into its place, tens. So the number, therefore the two digit number is equal to 10th place 8 minus x is my digit. 8 minus x is in 10th place. Yes? And x is in 1th place. I hope you understood. Once again, I am telling, listen. When I am writing any number, 732. Okay. 7 is in 100th place. That number into 100. So, this number is in, digit is in tens place. So digit into 10, its place value. Okay. Expanded form I'm using. 7 into 100, 3 into 10, plus 2 into 1. So in tens place, 8 minus x is my digit. So 8 minus x into 10, and 1 place, x is my digit. So x into 1. So this is somewhat logical question. So observe carefully and understand. So what is that? Whenever we are getting a number, by adding their place value. Yes or no? By adding the place value of each digit. So place value of 2 is 2 into 1 because it is in 1's place. 3 is in 10's place. That's why 3 into 10. And 7 is in 100's place. That's why 7 into 100. By adding all those numbers, we are getting the number. That's why I am also using the expanded form. Digit at the 10th place is 8 minus x. So place value is 8 minus x into 10. Plus in units place the digit is x. So 1. X into 1 is its place value. Okay. Now, so this is the required number. So simplify this first. 8 into 10, 80 minus 10 into x 10x plus x into 1 x is equal to brackets we have removed 80 minus 10 minus 1 the 9 that is minus 9x because 10 is having minus 10 so minus 9x so like that that is the required number but when 18 is added its digits are reversed so if we are adding eighteen to the number, the digits are reversed in that number. The digits are reversed. So observe why I am giving. Adding 18 to the number. So this is the number. 80 minus 9x plus 18. When I am adding 18, I am getting reverse order. That means this digit I will get in 1's place, x I will get in 10's place. So that means x is in 10's place, I will get, okay? And 8 minus x I will get in units place. I hope you understand. So if I am reversing the numbers, see by reversing, how I will get? By reversing, how I will get this 1's number, I will get in the 10's number. So digit x is in 1's place, that I will get in 10's place. And 8 minus x is in 10's place, so that I will get in a 1's place. If it is 78 only, 7 into 10 plus 8 into 1. Then reverse reality, now 87 I will put. And 8 into 10 plus 7 into 1. ఓకే అంటే ఈ డిజిట్ ఇక్కడికి వచ్చేస్తుంది ఈ డిజిట్ ఇక్కడికి వస్తుంది నా దగ్గర ఇప్పుడు ఎక్స్ వచ్చేసి ఫస్ట్ ప్లేస్కి వచ్చింది ఎయిట్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వచ్చేసి సెకండ్ ప్లేస్కి వచ్చింది సో వెన్ ఎవర్ వీఆర్ రివర్సింగ్ లైక్ దట్ నౌ సింప్లిఫై 80 ప్లస్ 18 దట్ ఈస్ 98 మైనస్ 9x ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 10 ఇంటూ ఎక్స్ ఈస్ 10x ప్లస్ 1 ఓన్లీ సో 8 మైనస్ ఎక్స్ Now 98 minus 9x is equal to 10 minus x is 9x plus 8. So bring variable terms one side and constant terms one side. Minus 9x we have left side. Bring another 9x also this side. Minus 9x plus 9x is there. So by bringing this side minus 9x which is equal to 8 we have x right side. So plus 98 we are bringing another side. So that will become minus 98. So which is equal to minus 9 minus 10. Both are negative values. So add minus 18x is equal to 8 minus 98. One is positive, one is negative subtraction. So 98 minus 8 is 90. But 98 is having minus 10, so minus 90. Then x will be equal to minus 90 by minus 18. Minus minus will get cancelled. 18 ones are 18 fives are. So x is equal to 5. Okay. Now x value 5 we got. So what is the number? 80 minus 9 into 5. 9 5 is 45. So 10 minus 5 is 5. 7 minus 4 is 3. So the required number is 35. Therefore, the number is equal to 80 minus 9x, that is 80 minus 9 into 5, x value we got 5. So 80 minus 9, 5 is 45. 80 minus 45 is nothing but 35. So the number, whatever we need, that number is 35. If you are if you have any doubt, add 18 to this number, we'll get 53. So like this, we need to simplify whenever digits question is given. So not only sum, they will give different also. In that case also, you need to follow the same thing. Okay. When 18 is added means plus 18 we return. So subtracted, difference means minus, you need to write whatever number given. Okay. This is the way to simplify. Once again, I am explaining because it is somewhat difficult. Observe the question carefully. So in the question, they only given that it is a two-digit number. Two-digit number means there is two place values, ones, tens. Okay, that's right. And they are given sum of the two digits is equal to 8. So given sum of two digits is equal to 8. Once digit, so what I am taking, once digit of the number is x. And tens digit number is equal to 8 minus x. Okay, because sum is 8, compulsory that will be 8 minus x. Okay, for suppose I have total 10 chocolates. Okay. Another person is having I and my friend both are having 10 chocolates. I have 6 chocolates. Then my friend will have 6 plus 4. That is 10 minus 6. That is nothing but 4. So 8 minus x is a 10th digit. Okay. Now the 2-digit number. So when we are writing expanded form, in 10th place we have 8 minus x. In 1st place we have x. So by simplifying this, we have got 80 minus 9. After that, they are given another condition. When 18 is added to the number, the digits are reversed. So when I am adding 18 to the given number, I am getting the answer as reverse order. Means x will take to 10th place, 8 minus x will come under 1st digit, 1st place. So like that, by simplifying both sets, we got the variables. By simplifying that equation, linear equation, we got the x value. But we don't want not only x, we have to get what is the original number. So substitute whatever we got the original number, substitute x value, we will get the answer. Okay. Now coming to the next type of question. So in two ways how we need to simplify this question, I have explained for you. So if you are getting for objective type question, don't waste this much time. For that sake only I have used I have shown one easiest method for you. Now coming to the next question. Example 16. So again this is one more type. A motorboat goes down a motor boat goes downstream in a river. Downstream in a river. And covers the distance between distance between two towns in five hours. It covers this distance upstream in 6 hours. If the speed of the stream is 2 kilometers per hour, find the speed of the boat in still water. Okay, just read the question, then you will understand easily. A motorboat goes downstream in a river and covers the distance between two towns in 5 hours. So there are two towns. Let A and B. Two towns are there. In that, it is going downstream. Okay? To go to the downstream, A to B, downside. Like this, it is moving, boat. Okay? Water also flows downside only, downstream. So that flow is very fast. So just observe. Okay, I'll tell you. Water also flows in this direction only freely. Okay, now it covers this distance upstream in 6 hours. So it is in downstream. Downstream. And when boat is coming in the upstream, upstream, it is taking 6 hours. So here it is taking 5 hours. It is taking 6 hours to complete the distance. Now, if the speed of the stream is 2 km/h, that means water speed is equal to 2 km/h. So water speed is equal to 2 km/h. Speed of the stream is 2 km/h. Find the speed of the boat in still water. Still water means there is no flow. In still water, what will be the speed of the boat? Asking speed. So this question is related to speed, time, distance. Yes or no? So what we have the formula for that? Speed is equal to distance by time. It is like your physical question, physical science question. So now observe. First, I am taking what we need to find speed of the boat in still water. So let the speed of the water in still water, means there is no change in the water, in still water is equal to x kilometers per hour. Okay. So observe, when it is going in the downstream, boat is traveling to the downstream, whatever speed of the boat is there, that speed plus water speed also will be added. Means downstream will add it to the original speed of the boat. Why? Because there is no force, no opposite direction. Directly it is going. So ipudu water kindiki flow ayinappudu ee direction kindiki vellatappudu aa force మన బోట్ ఉండే ఫోర్స్ కి ఇది కాస్త ఫోర్స్ యాడ్ అయ్యి కాస్త ఎక్కువ స్పీడ్ తో వెళ్తుంది. అదే ఆపోజిట్ డైరెక్షన్ లో వచ్చింది అనుకోండి, వాటర్ ఏమో కిందికి ఫ్లో అవుతున్నాయి ఈజీగా, అండ్ బోట్ అప్ స్ట్రీమ్ కి వస్తుంది, పైకి వస్తుంది. పైకి వచ్చేటప్పుడు అవి రివర్స్ లో వస్తాయి కాబట్టి అది ఆ స్పీడ్ అనేది తగ్గుద్ది. బోట్ స్పీడ్ విల్ బి డిడక్టెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ విత్ ద వాటర్ స్పీడ్, అండ్ హియర్ బోట్ స్పీడ్ ఫర్ బోట్ స్పీడ్ వాటర్ స్పీడ్ విల్ బి యాడెడ్. మీన్స్ వాట్ ఐఎమ్ రైటింగ్, so in downstream speed of the boat is equal to speed of the boat is equal to x plus 2 km/h. Okay, I hope you understood why I am telling plus 2, because water also flowing and the same direction of the boat, because downstream, that is going to downstream, so that's why plus 2. That means what is the speed of the water, that one also added to the actual speed of the boat. X, actual speed of the boat is x, and water is flowing 2 km/h. So that sum we have to take while we are taking in the downstream. And coming to the distance covered, so it is speed is nothing but distance by time. So for distance, x plus 2 km/h. So for 1 hour, x plus 2 km, it is going in the downstream. So the speed of the boat distance covered by boat in downstream. For 1 hour is equal to x plus 2 kilometers. Since speed is equal to, here speed is equal to distance by time. So distance is x plus 2 kilometers per hour. That is x plus 2 by 1 hour given. So distance is equal to x plus 2 kilometers. So here I'll write that. So we have speed is equal to distance by time. So for 1 hour we are taking the speed, that is x plus 2 kilometers per hour. So for 1 hour distance will be equal to x plus 2 kilometers. That's why we got x plus 2 kilometers. Okay, now coming to the next condition. Sorry, this is x plus 2 kilometers. So when it is going, it is taking how many hours time? 5 hours. So how much distance covered by the boat in downstream? Therefore, distance covered by boat in 5 hours in the downstream only. Okay, because they are given time 5 hours. Okay, that is the distance between A and B covered by boat in 5 hours. That is distance between A and B. Distance between A and B is equal to 5 into x plus 2. For 1 hour, x plus 2 kilometers. For 5 hours, 5 into x plus 2 kilometers. When it is moving downstream, till now I have explained downstream only. Just observe, when it is moving downstream, water current also pushing the boat with the speed of 2 kilometers per hour. So total speed of the boat will become x plus 2 kilometers per hour. Now, distance covered by boat for 1 hour. 1 hour is equal to x plus 2 kilometers because we have speed is equal to distance by time. So it is distance by time. For 1 hour, x plus 2 kilometers distance covered by the boat. For 5 hours, so it is taking to cover the distance between A and B, 5 hours. So the distance, how much covered, is equal to 5 into x plus 2 kilometers. Till now finished. Same procedure we need to check for upstream also. So downstream we got this much. The speed of the boat in upstream. So when is both are coming up opposite direction, compulsory it will opposite to water current. Means water current will opposite to the boat. That addukuntadi kabatti minus 2 cheyali. So boat speed will be in upstream. Speed of the boat will become x minus 2 kilometers per hour. Yes, kilometers per hour. That means the distance covered in 1 hour in upstream is equal to x minus 2 kilometers. Therefore, to complete this, to cover distance between A and B, it is taking 6 hours. So for 6 hours, the distance is equal to A and B distance only. This one also 6 hours, 6 into x minus 2 kilometers. But in still water, the distance between AB is equal. So in still water, 5x, 5 into x plus 2 must be equal to 6 into x minus 2. That's all. So now find out x value. 5x plus 10 is equal to 6x minus 12. So bring x term one side. 5x minus 6x is equal to minus 12 minus 10. Then minus x is equal to minus 22. Minus minus will get cancelled. X is equal to 22 kilometers per hour. So speed of the boat is equal to 22 kilometers per hour. So just once again I am explaining. Very simple question, but somewhat logically given. So when actual speed of the boat is equal to x kilometer per hour. Speed of the boat. And in downstream, speed of the boat will become x plus 2 kilometers per hour. Okay, in downstream, so that water speed also will be added to the boat. That's why x plus 2 kilometers per hour. And for 1 hour, it is covering the distance x plus 2 kilometers. For 5 hours, 5 into x plus 2 kilometers, it is completely downstream. Coming to upstream, the both speed will become x minus 2 kilometers per hour. So distance covered for 1 hour is equal to x minus 2 kilometers. Okay, and for 6 hours, 6 into x minus 2 kilometers. But in still water, the distance is the same. A to B and A to B only we are finding the distance. So speed is same in the still water. That's why 5 into x plus 2 is equal to 6 into x minus 2. By simplifying that x value, you will get as 22 kilometers per hour. So the speed of the boat in still water is equal to 22 kilometers per hour. 1 hour it is covering 22 kilometers. That's all. Now coming to the next question. So today whatever we have discussed, the first one we have different problems we have discussed. First we are thought about the linear equation, parallel lines and transversal concept. And next example I have shown you how the edges problem related with this type of equation. And thirdly I have explained when sum of the digits in a number, how we have to use to simplify, how we need to use the equations to simplify the given to find the actual number. So that one we have discussed in the third example. And my last example is depending on the speed and distance concept. Okay, now coming to the next question. Now we will solve some of the questions from the exercise. So now I am explaining exercise 2.4 problems. So now I'll explain exercise 2.4 problems. My first question is, find the value of x. Find the value of x so that L is parallel to M. So the figure is given in this way. L is parallel to M means compulsory we will get the transversal concept. L is parallel to M and here P 3x minus 10 degrees, 2x plus 15 degrees. So like this they are given, okay. Now observe, find the value of x so that L is parallel to M. So given in the question only, like our first example, given L is parallel to M, so P is a transversal. Because P is meeting L and M at different points. So let those point as RS. Okay. Now, what we have to find? X value we have to find. So that means, first of all, which type of angles are those we need to find? 2x plus 15, 3x minus 10. Observe here, these two are related anyway. Just observe. This is the transversal. One is lying this side and other is lying another side. And both are exterior angles, observe. So these two are exterior alternate angles. In case of parallel lines, alternate angles are equal. So 2x plus 15 is equal to 3x minus 10. So what I am writing? 2x plus 15 degrees and 3x minus 10 degrees are lying either side of the transversal. Either side of the transversal. And both are exterior. Therefore, 2x plus 15 and 3x minus 10 angles are alternate exterior angles. Exterior alternate angles. So in case of parallel lines, exterior alternate or interior alternate, all are equal. Therefore, 2x plus 15 is equal to 3x minus 10, since L is parallel to M. That's why those two angles are equal. So now, try to bring variables one side. So now we got finally both sides variables, linear equation which is having both sides variables. Okay, 2x minus 3x is equal to minus 10 minus 15. So minus x will be equal to minus 25, minus minus will get cancelled. X is equal to 25. So what is the value of x? 25. So if you have any doubt whether it is correct or not, check. 25 into 2, 2x, 2 into 25, 50. 50 plus 15 is a 65 degrees. Coming to this one, 3 into 25, 25, 3 is a 75. 75 minus 10, 65. So both are same. Means whatever we got x value, that is correct. So in case of parallel lines, you need to remember that corresponding angles always equal. Alternate angles always equal, and co-interior angles sum is equal to 180 degrees. So these three conditions we have to remember every time. Already several problems you have simplified in your previous class, but then also you need to remember these topics. So actually this one no need to write. Okay, but why we are calling them exterior alternate angles, for that I am giving the reason. Okay, now coming to the next, second question. Okay, observe the second question. 8 times of a number. Okay children, next exercise problems in the next class we are going to discuss. Today whatever